What's up guys, this is Matthias aka Ruler's Poker, and in this part I want to show you how to utilize the custom mode of vision in order to practice preflop simulations from Moncasova. So I've prepared here the Moncasova simulation. I want to practice the small blind open raising a little bit since I think that I'm leaking there. So let's go to vision and go to the practice and custom mode. So given we're interested in the small blind, let's set it up real quick here. So I'm here in the small blind and the big blind is here. So that's pretty much the minimum configuration that I would recommend. You can also, of course, now add other players, and you can even signalize that they already folded by typing like fold in the bubble. But yeah, we can also leave it at the minimum requirements and leave it like this. The name is optional. Let's call it small blind RFI. And the pot size is also optional, but yeah, I would just recommend you to set it up like this. The board is important to that you leave it empty, because yeah, then the hands filter and the search engine will be optimized for preflop. And last but not least, we are copy pasting the ranges from Moncasova. So we open up here Moncasova and again go with the fold, copy to clipboard and paste it in here, and do the same thing for the limping and the raising. Now we go with fold, call and raise, and go to generate. So yeah, these ranges are a little bigger, so yeah, already there. Okay, so first hand, ace, queen, check, seven. I would say with the ace high suit, we are going for a raise here. And we can see raise is the correct answer. And we can also see that we now see exactly the components that play different. So with this hand, we see that ace, the suited ace is open raising. Also, if we are rainbow, we are open raising this hand, but then prefer to limp with the triple suited versions and the single suited versions that are not to the nuts, also raising the double suited ones. So that's definitely already nice to get a little bit of an overview of these hand types. So let's go with a new one, ace, king, check, nine. I think the rainbow ones were a raise, so this is the same for this one as well. And we see still some limping here with this. So yeah, let's go through some more. 6-4 deuce, definitely too weak. And we can also select the quick round. So as you see, there's a little bit of a delay given the ranges are kind of big. So you can also go for the quick rounds, and then the search will not load, only if you have an incorrect answer. So now fold, and we can immediately generate a new hand. Queen, queen, seven deuce, could be both call and raise. Let's go with the call, correct. 8-6-4-4, also correct. So yeah, looks like I'm doing kind of decentish at the moment. So yeah, maybe let's do an incorrect answer. Then we can see that if we give an incorrect answer, the search will still come. And yeah, now we see again the categories. So A754 seems to be very relevant, what suits we have. And then we can also go ahead and take an exact look at the hands, just to see what are the ones in case we have a mixed category, which wasn't the case here. But if you had a mixed category, then we can take a look at, yeah, we can also, by the way, with the quick rounds, search manually if we are interested in maybe other categories. So yeah, this is how this will work. So let's see if I get anything wrong here. Ace check, eight deuce. Yeah, this is maybe a trickier one. Nope, also correct. So here, for example, ace, check, 6-3, we have a mixed category. So if you open it up, we can see that we have the limp if the ace, check is suited. So yeah, we can see the pattern here very clearly. And then we have the rays if we have the good suits. So yeah, this way we can figure this out. Also pretty fast. So maybe let's do one different spot now. Let's go to the button. So button first in, go ahead and copy the fold, get rid of these, and copy the rays. Set it up here again, and click on generate. And we should also, by the way, change the board here, so the visualization. So now we are here on the button, and yeah, the rest is fine. This is okay. So yeah, now we get the same hands for the big for the button. So tangent used use. I think all the double pairs are in open rays, and this is correct. So we have a 54-46 distribution. And for example, yeah, there are a lot of clear hands, as we saw, like double suited queens, of course, open raising, these nines, of course, folding. So what we can do now is go to the hands filter, and we can remove the components that we think are pretty easy and clear. So for sure, the high pairs, for sure, ace plus three broadways, ace plus two broadways, four broadways, three broadways for the most part. For the rundowns, let's get also rid of the no-gap rundowns. So with this combination, let's maybe get rid of the double-suited hands and now go to new hands. So this will take up to 10 seconds for like very big ranges, as we have for preflop, given that preflop we have all the hands. But after the 10 seconds, you can switch the filters around as you want, and everything is already loaded and you can adjust it. So 6-4-3-3 looks like a fold. We can also take a look at the filter here again. So if we click on filter, we can see that the selection we have made here is 29% raising. So yeah, we are maybe a little bit too much on the folding end here. Ace-check 9 deuce. Already a close one, but raising is correct. And we can see again the hands that raise, the hands that fold. So with the three suits, we start folding a little bit. Queen 887 would also go with the raise and fold with the three suits. But no, the three suits would also be an open raise. Check 9-5 deuce, pretty clear. Queen 10-9 deuce, I would say raise is correct, but very close. So now again, I would open up the category and we can see that. So yeah, okay, so the queen high suit seems to be mandatory. It doesn't seem to matter whether the queen 10 is suited or the queen 9, but we can also see that if the queen is not suited, the 10 suited or the 9 suited, we are folding this category.